Put God first, have an inspire faith in the Almighty.
Are you perfect? No one is perfect. But how do you know? There is no exact point on what perfect really is, up on people that is. I mean, getting a perfect in a quiz is perfect, but it doesn't mean that you're perfect. It only means that you are smart. Now take this test. This test will check if you are perfect or not. Try the test, and maybe you'll be able to tell that you are perfect. Schroeder. But, if you're perfect, Schroeder. But, if you're perfect. Don't scare me with your perfectness. I may shudder so hard I might melt.
Hey you, the person that tagged you to this video wants to say this prayer for you. Dear God, I love this person with all my heart. Please give them the breakthrough their life truly deserves. They have the most kindest spirit, the most selfless soul, and the most giving heart. They truly deserve all the peace, all the joy, all the blessings that you're about to give to their life. Amen.
Hi, my babies. I just want to say thank you to all the new followers. There's a lot and they keep coming. It's crazy. But with that being said, I want to put this out there, just so you know what you get yourself into when you see my posts. I call you guys my babies because you are my babies. Because I love unconditionally. That's one thing I want my page known to be, is that I'm real, authentic. I don't sugarcoat stuff, and I just give the messages that I'm given to spread love, not judgment. On my page, there is no judgment. If you are perfect, please unfollow me. If you are perfect, please unfollow me, because I'm not perfect. I swear, it might offend people. I get passionate and it comes out of my mouth. So if I swear and it offends you, then you probably should unfollow me. Because then you're not really listening to my messages anyway. You're focusing on the negative instead of the positive. You see, I'm not perfect. I made this platform to be real and to love people as they are. Because God says, come as you are, with all your imperfections, and let me love you anyway. He didn't say, come as you are, only if you don't swear, only if you never have sex, and only if this, this, and this. Yes, we all try to be better people, but we are not perfect. So if you want to come on my page and cast judgment on me because I swear, then you really need to reevaluate yourself. I left the church because of judgment, because I never felt good enough. I want my page to be a page that people feel safe, that they can be themselves. I don't care if you're gay. I don't care if you're blue. I don't care if you're an alien. I don't care if you say that fuck word. I do not care. As long as you know that you are loved unconditionally by God, that's all that I care about. So if you do not like my stuff, if you do not like my content, if you have a problem with it and you want to say a prayer for my soul because I said the F word, please unfollow me, because you are not understanding what God is trying to say. I love everyone. But this is me. I've been this way for 2.5 years, and I take pride in the fact that I don't have to change who I am to be loved. And neither do you. So have the most amazing day filled with love in every way. And remember, if you are perfect, unfollow me.
God will find you. Sunland Apple IPTV Entertainment. Perfected Faces, done by Candy.
See, I didn't find God in the church. In fact, I didn't find God at all. He found me. He met me in a place where I was so broken, I couldn't get up. And when you're loved like that, it will shock you.
Whoever needs to hear this, listen now. God did not bring you this far to leave you. He did not bring you this far to... The scripture says that he that started a good work, he starts a good work. He's faithful to see it through till the end. The work that the Lord has started in you is a good work, and He will surely see it through to the end. He says, He makes all things work together for good for those that love the Lord and are called according to His purpose. His purpose. You did not find God. Contrary to the way it explained today that, oh, I found God. You did not find God. God was not lost. You was lost. God found you. And so if He finds you, He is big enough, strong enough, and able enough to secure you and to keep you. You've got to believe that. In the book of Matthew chapter 6, verse 44, it says, "No one can come to you unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up at the last day." Christ is saying that if the Father did not send you, if the Father did not send you to Him, you will not be able to know Him. So God found you. So you've got to believe that if He found you and He's brought you this far, then He's faithful enough, He's able enough, and He's more than willing to see you through to the very end, because He does a good work. He doesn't do unfinished business. No, the Lord finishes His work perfectly. The book of Ephesians 2 verses 10 says that we are God's masterpiece. We are God's masterpiece. Listen to these words. Created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared for us a long time ago. So before you were even born, there was a preparation for you. You've got to believe that, because it's true. Before you were formed in your mother's womb, I knew you. I've set you apart. Right? So there's a preparation for you. There's a plan for you. There's a purpose for you. There's a path for you. And you are a masterpiece that is going through to perfection. You will be perfected. You're going through a process that is going to take you to perfection. The Lord did not bring you this far to me.
God wants to be pursued. He's a relational God. He's a jealous God. He wants your heart. He wants your devotion. He wants your passion. In fact, He gives us an incredible promise in Jeremiah 29, verse 13. He says this, God says, "You will seek me," and what happens when you seek me? When you seek me, He says, you'll find me. It's a promise. If you pursue God, He will reveal Himself to you. You will seek me and find me. When you seek me with all your heart, God says, I will be found by you, declares the Lord. When you draw near to Him, when you pursue Him, when you crave Him, when you hunger for Him, God loves to be pursued, and He loves to reveal Himself to you.
To speak to people about a peg. So when you look at a peg, Sister Lerato, there's this silver spring in the center.
Yes.
A peg cannot function without the silver spring in the center. If I remove the silver spring in the center, it'll be just two pieces of planks that mean nothing. Same thing with your life. If I remove God at the center of your heart, you'll be a meaningless person. You wouldn't know your purpose. You wouldn't know your calling. You wouldn't know who you are. Number two, when you hang clothes on a line, why do you put a peg? You put a peg so that impacts a zinga or zinga gold. Same thing with your life. Why do you receive God in your life? You receive God so that you don't fall into depression, anger, anxiety, bitterness, jealousy. That is why you need God in your life, so that you can be who you are and know your identity and purpose. Number three, if I remove the clothes from the pegs, impahla zonzakalayo, this is all. So that is why it's very important to stick onto the Lord. Number four, Apex does not discriminate, Sister Lerato. It doesn't matter whether you are rich, whether you are poor, whether you are filthy, whether you are dirty. Apex's job is to hold you back. It does not matter who you are. Apex is going to hold you. Isn't this the same thing that God says? Come as you are. It doesn't matter how broken. It doesn't matter what happened in your life. God is saying that just come as you are. Right now, during this lockdown, there's somebody that's broken. It's saying that I have no future. There's no hope, Bongan. But I want to tell you, God is saying, come as you are. And the word fear, Sisley Rato, the word fear, this word, fear, it has two meanings for me, Sisley Rato. It says, first meaning from the enemy. And people will say, forget everything and run away from the promises that God has for you. It's saying forget. But I want you to turn it around today. I don't care what situation you're facing today. Turn it around. Face everything and rise. I don't care what situation you've been through. A lot of people, they might have thrown stones. Like dogs do not bark at a car that stands still. But dogs bark at a car that's moving. So what I'm telling you, run. Hustle. It's difficult. Today I'm an author, Sisley Rato. My friends, when I shut my...
In the mirror lately, wish you could trade eyes with me. There's complexities in complexion, but your skin is glow like diamonds. Dig me like the earth, you be giving birth to everything alive, baby, know your worth. I love everything about you, from your nappy curls to every single curve, your body natural. Same skin that was broken, me the same skin taking over. Most things are the focus view, but when you're in the room, they notice you. Cause you're beautiful. Yeah, you're beautiful. Them and them gon' fall in love with you in all of your glory. Your skin is not only dark, it shines and it tells your story. Keep dancing, they can't control you. They watch and they all adore you.